The head of the U.S. Strategic Command has called for serious consideration of a return to deploying intercontinental ballistic missiles, or ICBMs, with multiple nuclear warheads. The U.S. Air Force's LGM-30G Minuteman III ICBMs have this capability, but operational examples are presently only loaded with one warhead due to arms control agreements with Russia. But its successor, Sentinel ICBM, could be deployed with more than one warhead. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. STRATCOM boss wants Sentinel ICBM to be armed with multiple warheads. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. U.S. Strategic Command, or STRATCOM, boss Air Force General Anthony Cotton, while testifying before members of the Senate, pointed to the importance of returning to deploying ICBMs with more than one warhead, also known as Multiple Independently Targetable Reentry Vehicle, or MIRV, configuration. Viewers may note that STRATCOM oversees the U.S. military's triad of nuclear deterrent forces, which include silo-based ICBMs, nuclear-capable bombers, and nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. Cotton told the assembled members of the Senate Armed Services Committee, "I do believe that we need to take serious considerations in seeing what uploading and re-MIRVing the ICBM looks like, and what does it take to potentially do that." Cotton was responding to a question about which of the 81 recommendations in a report from the Congressional Commission on the Strategic Posture of the United States that was published last year he wanted to be prioritized. The Strategic Posture Commission's specific recommendation regarding MIRVing is to plan to deploy the Sentinel ICBM in a MIRVed configuration. A Multiple Independently Targetable Reentry Vehicle, or MIRV, is a ballistic missile payload containing several warheads, each capable of being aimed to hit a different target. MIRV allows separately targeted nuclear warheads to be sent on their independent ways after the main propulsion stages of the missile launch have shut down. Minuteman III was the first true MIRV-capable missile. It can carry a maximum of 3 warheads, and these can be independently targeted against 3 different locations. When the Minuteman III first entered service in 1970, it had a MIRV configuration with 3 W-62 warheads. Those were subsequently replaced by the W-78s. Successive U.S.-Russian arms control agreements led to the LGM-118A peacekeepers being removed from service in 2005, and the total number of warheads in each of the remaining Minuteman III being reduced to 1. Currently, of the 400 Minuteman IIIs that the U.S. Air Force has deployed, each either has a single W-78 in a Mark 12A reentry vehicle or a W-87 warhead in a Mark 21 reentry vehicle. The W-78 has a reported yield of around 335 kilotons. The W-87s used on Minuteman IIIs came from decommissioned peacekeepers. The original yield of the W-87 was 300 kilotons, but there is a variant designated as W-87-1 that has a maximum yield of about 475 kilotons. The Sentinels are set to replace Minuteman III on a one-for-one basis. The current plan is for each Sentinel ICBM to be loaded with a single W-87-1 nuclear warhead inside a Mark 21A reentry vehicle when the missile enters service, which is expected to begin in the 2030s. The Sentinel ICBM design as revealed by the US Air Force, includes the capability for a MIRV configuration. Russia and China are America's current main nuclear competitors, both field, road mobile, and silo-based ICBMs with MIRV configurations. The main limiting factor currently to the US military returning to using MIRVed ICBMs is the 2010 New START Treaty, which imposes restrictions on how many total strategic warheads, as well as delivery platforms, the United States and Russia can have deployed at any one time. The treaty defines each reentry vehicle on an ICBM or SLBM, as well as individual nuclear-capable heavy bombers, as counting as a single warhead. So, under New START, in order to deploy MIRVed Sentinels, or even re-MIRVing existing Minuteman III's, the US military would have to reduce warheads deployed through bombers or ballistic missile submarines. But this restriction could cease to exist. The New START Treaty is scheduled to expire in 2026, and amid the current geopolitical uncertainties, there's no assurance that a comparable agreement with Russia can be successfully negotiated as a replacement. Last year, the Russian government suspended its participation in New START in response to US support for Ukraine. Efforts by the United States to engage China in a new trilateral nuclear arms control agreement, alongside negotiations with Russia, have not produced any substantial results so far. China has used this situation to significantly ramp up its nuclear warhead production and deployment. General Cotton said at the hearing, "Would I love to see China step up and want to have a negotiation with us? Would I love to see Russia come back? Absolutely. But I'm also a realist who understands that that may or may not happen. So as a combatant commander, my job is to understand how do I build a force that I could present to the president if that doesn't happen." A MIRV configuration not only increases the total number of targets that a single missile can strike, but also complicates things for enemy defenders by increasing the volume of threats they have to contend with. The US Air Force has fired MIRVed Minuteman III's without live nuclear warheads as part of routine testing in recent years, demonstrating that those missiles retain that capability. While the timing and method of the US military reintroducing ICBMs with multiple warheads are uncertain, the latest developments seem to have set this process in motion. General Cotton's statements from STRATCOM, aligning with the recommendations of the Congressional Strategic Posture Commission, indicate a noticeable resurgence of US interest in MIRVed ICBMs.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.